Hi, this is Jennifer Workmeister, product manager with Adobe Content Analytics. Today, I'm going to introduce you to the Content Analytics product and teach you about the different Content Analytics components and how you can use them to analyze and optimize your content. So let's start with our most basic question. What content is performing best? To start, I'm going to look at the assets. That's all the images on my site. Here, I've made a table that helps me to understand how my assets are performing based on the multiple metrics that I care about. I'm able to see how many times each asset has been viewed, how many times it's been clicked on, its click-through rate, how many people have seen it, and then, what is most important to me, how much revenue I can attribute to that asset being seen. Here, I've applied a linear attribution model. That means that if someone makes a purchase, the credit for that purchase will be evenly distributed over all the assets that that person has seen. But you have the option of using any of the customer journey analytics attribution models to choose how you want to attribute revenue to the content based on when in the customer journey it has been seen. For example, you can use a first touch, a last touch, or a J-curve attribution model. In this table, I'm comparing 1 week to the week before to see how performance of my content has changed. This is useful for identifying trends of when content is getting stale. One of the useful features we've added for content analytics is the ability to click into the thumbnails of your content for a little extra information. If I click this asset, I can see a larger version. I can also see how many times it has been seen for all time. This is different than the impressions metric that I have in my table, which only looks at my selected date range. This view shows me its all-time impressions, when it was first seen and when it was last seen, so I can easily identify how long this asset has been shown to my customers and if it might be getting stale. This panel also shows all the attributes assigned to this asset. Asset attributes are important for identifying not just what content is performing well, but why it is performing well, and what kind of content is likely to perform well in the future. Lastly, we can see what experiences this asset has appeared in. Experiences are unique units of content that contain both text and images. It looks like this shoe has appeared in 7 different experiences. Let's take a look at what they are. Now I can see each experience that the shoe appeared in, as well as the revenue attributed to each one of those experiences. Just like assets, I can click on the experience info button and get a better view and a little bit more information about that experience. Just as I can look at the performance of my individual assets, I can also look at the performance of my experiences. Again, understanding the views, clicks, click-through rate, and attributed revenue of each. And just as I am able to break down an asset by the experiences it appears in, I can break down the experience by the assets they contain. As you saw, instead of clicking a breakdown button, I was able to drag the asset ID from the left rail. All content analytics components will appear here alongside the rest of your dimensions and metrics. This means that I can use them in other workspace visualizations. A scatter plot is a great way to quickly identify what is working and what isn't on your site. Here, I have plotted all of my images based on impressions and revenue. As you can see, the attributed revenue is closely correlated with how much that image has been seen. I can quickly spot that this image, Mountain Trail Run, is an outlier bringing in comparatively high revenue for how often it has been viewed. I'd want to look at the experiences this appeared in to see if it was maybe associated with a promotion or something else that would make it an outlier. And with that information, I can judge if maybe it's an image that just really resonates with my audience, and maybe I should promote it more on my site. Content Analytics uses AI and GenAI to automatically assign every asset metadata, like subjects, scenes, foreground colors, etc. There is a dimension for each attribute category, like foreground color. But we've also created one super dimension with all the attributes in one. This lets you see what of all the attributes are most impactful. It may be only the color red, a specific subject, and a specific background scene. With the asset attributes dimension, you'll be able to look at them all at once. In these charts, I'm looking at the total revenue and percent change associated with my assets. It looks like I've had a largely negative percent change in performance from 1 week to the next, but the foreground color green is spiking as performing better than last week. Let's take a look at its performance in the chart. It looks like the color has had a surge in popularity over the last couple of days. This is a trend that may be worth paying attention to. As I mentioned, there's a special dimension item for each attribute category, so you can evaluate the impact of just foreground colors, people categories, background scenes, and much more. Now that we've talked about image attributes, what about text? Content Analytics assigns text attributes at the experience level. Text attributes contain things like word and paragraph counts, keywords, and my favorites, narratives, persuasion strategies, and marketing emotions. As with asset attributes, we have one big text attribute dimension for looking at them all at once, and individual dimensions for each category like keywords or narratives. Now for the real magic. Content analytics allows you to discover what content and what attributes of content are resonating with which audience segments and allows you to optimize accordingly. Let's take that table on marketing emotions from earlier. Let's say I want to find out what was the most effective marketing emotion for a particular segment. All I need to do is drop that segment into the panel. If I sort this by revenue, I can quickly see which marketing emotion was equated with the most revenue for this particular segment. It looks like aspiration followed by recognition are the most effective marketing emotions to use for this segment. You can also easily compare segments against each other to see whether or not it is worth optimizing for each segment. This time, let's look at asset engagement, so I'll pick asset click-through rate. And let's look at an asset attribute, like asset objects. Dropping in my two different segments, I can quickly look at the bar graphs here and see that while there are not very large differences, a couple of things jump out at me. Mostly, that repeat purchasers are not quite as engaged with images of bikes. I would use this same strategy to quickly understand how my audiences with different interests, like trail runners versus yoga enthusiasts, respond to different scenes and subjects, and use that information to form an interest-based personalization strategy. I hope this has helped you to understand content analytics and how content analytics can help inform your content strategies. Thank you.